So in this session, we will discuss about sorting and limiting and pagination and regular expressions and passing table name as a parameter, passing column values as a parameter, comparison query operators, logical query operators, and getting the documents, I mean, what are the examples of NOT operator. Okay. So how to display the collection count and how to get the distinct values from the collection. Okay. And what is index, how to create the index, and how to drop the index, unique index, all those things we will discuss. So first of all, sorting and limiting. Here, this is our database, EMP and the department collections are there. So first of all, what is mean by sorting? You double click on collection, you will get the documents from this collection. Okay, so here, suppose if I want to display the employee details based on salary, either decreasing or increasing, then sorting technique will be used. So sorting shows how to sort returned documents by one or more fields in ascending and descending orders. So here salary is not in ascending order. So you can use sort method. Here, I want to display the documents based on salary ascending order. So now you can able to see the documents based on salary in ascending order. So if you put minus one, then you can able to see the documents based on salary descending order. Okay. Now you can give multiple columns in this sorting. Okay. Like I want to display the employee details based on department number and salary. So here we give like this. So here 10 is there, 20 is there, again 20, 30, again 10 will come. That means there is no order. So I am giving order. Sorry, department number field is not there. So that you need to give the field name DEPT dot department number. Why? Because department number exists in DEPT object. Now you can able to see the employee related documents in ascending order of department number. Okay. Now here observe this. Salary is, and here 3000. Again here 1100. Okay. So I want to display the employee details based on department number and salary. So give salary column one. First, it will give preference to department number, and then it will give preference to salary. First, it will display all the department numbers according to the department number order. Okay. So department number 10 will come first. After that, in the department number 10, suppose three records are there. So it will display first record according to the salary, lowest salary. So that's why 1300 will come first, and 2450 will come next, After that, 5000. After that, department number 10 records are completed. So department number 20. Again, 800 comes first. Suppose I want to display the employee details based on department number, but salary should be in descending order. So you can write like this. So this time, department number 10 comes at first with salary of highest salary, 5000. Next highest salary, 2415, department number 10. So like that, we can write. That is about sorting. Next, limit. Limit means it is used to specify the number of returned documents for a query. It is here all the documents are displayed, but I don't want to display all the documents. I want to display limited amount of documents so that you can use limit function. In this, whatever you have specified, that much of documents only you will get. Suppose I'm specifying 5 series, so you will get 5 documents only. If you specify 3, you will get 3 documents like that. Okay. Next. Skip. See this. Here, I don't want to display first 3 records. Then you can use skip method. Okay. So skip of 3. See this. 11 from 1100 you are getting. See this. First 3 records are skipped. Okay, so this is the purpose of skip. So you can skip MongoDB. Okay, so how to implement this one is, so actually, do you know the pagination? So here, 14 records are there. In website, I don't want to display 14 records at a time. Okay. So I want to display 5 records in page number 1. And again, in page number 2, I want to display next 5 records. In page number 3, I want to display next 5 records. Okay. So how to implement this pagination? So here, first, limit of, before going to do that, I want to declare some variables, page number equal to 1, size equal to 5. So limit of size I am giving dot skip of page number minus 1 into size. See this? So here first five records I am displaying by using this query. The formula is limit of size. How many records you want to display, that count you need to give in limit function. Okay. So how many records you want to skip, that count, this is the formula. Okay. So page number minus one into size. Okay. Then you can get first five records. Okay. So suppose if you want to get next five records, then so actually according to our assumptions, next five records belongs to second page. Okay. So that you need to pass two here. This is from 1600 to 1500. 1600 to 1500 you will get. Okay. Suppose I want to display next five records, but here we are having only four records in the third page. Then you need to pass three here. Only four records from 950 to 1300. Okay. So how to implement the pagination means you need to give the size value to the limit and page number minus one into size. Okay, that is the formula for skip. So page number is three into three minus one into five. So 3 minus 1, 2 into 5, 10. That means we are using skip of 10 means it will skip the first 10 records. And limit of size, that means it will display up to 5 records only. Okay, so that you will get 5 records. So in third page, we are not having 15th records, so that you will get only 4 records. So this is about pagination. Okay. Did you understand this? Okay. Next one is regular expressions. So here searching in RDBMS. I want to have one employee details where so somebody is unmuting. Can you mute yourself? Suppose I want to have employee records whose employee name starts with yes, then this is the way to write the query. Okay, so like that, how to write the query in MongoDB? So db.emp.findOf. So first of all, we will discuss the examples one by one. So getting the documents based on search with specified character in any position of the string, including case sensitive. Suppose I am giving one letter, okay, whether that character exists in a particular field or not, we will check. So ename, I am checking ename contains yes or not. So it is returning zero records. Okay, that means suppose if I give capital S, let me see if it is exist or not. So it exists. Okay, yes, exists in each and every document here. That means so it is case sensitive. So here when I give small cap small s, then I won't get any records. So for ignoring the capital letters or small letters, I mean case instead, you can give I. Then it will ignore whether you have submitted capital letter or small letter. So you will get the records. That is about its specified character in any position of the string. So here yes contains starting position, ending position, starting position, ending position, ending position. Okay. So if I give A, see this, here A contains second position, this, here first position, third position also, second position, second, third. Okay. Next. With specified characters in any position of the string. So here I am passing only A. Okay. But I want to pass multiple characters. So then how to write the query? Simple. A, C. Okay. If you don't put I, then you will not get any records. Why? Because all the values in capital letters. See this. So A to C. Here in ename field, A to C, A hyphen C means A, B, C. So it will search L. It will search these three letters A, B, C. So here C is there. That's why Scott employee name will be displayed. Here A is there, A is there, A, A. Here A, C both are there. So if I give J, then it will check the letters from A to J. Between A to J, how many characters are there in ename field. So that documents will be displayed. Okay. That is multiple characters. Next one is specified character at starting position. So I want to have the employee details whose name starts with some particular special character. Okay. Not special character, specified character. So yes. So for this, this symbol, cap symbol will be used here. The employee name starts with yes. Okay. So the documents will be displayed. So for that, you need to use this type of symbol, cap symbol. Okay. So starting position, specified characters means, specified characters means, here this is single character. Specified characters means you need to give like this. Here, see this. So A to C, Adam starts with A, Alan starts with A, B starts with B, Blake starts with Blake, B, Clark starts with C. That's why these four records only displayed. Okay. So for verifying the starting positions, you need to give this symbol. Okay. And if you want to search with multiple characters, so you need to give square brackets. Next, ending position. For ending position, suppose I want to display the employee documents whose employee name ends with yes. For that, give dollar symbol. See this. These are the employee details whose name ends with yes. Okay. So for using multiple characters means you need to use square symbol, square brackets. A to C. So no records are there. J. So from A to J, these are the employee starts ends with the alphabets which lies between A to J. Okay. So this is about regular expressions. And how to pass the table name as a parameter. So we have seen here how to pass the names as a parameter. So db dot collection of A find emp, sorry, here this one is missed. See this. Suppose if I pass DAPT here, so you can get department details. Okay. Next one is passing column values. So I want to display the particular value like B equal to 20. Here I am passing department number. So DAPT number B. Okay, like that you will get. Next one is query operators, comparison query operators. First one is equal. So EQ. So I want to display the employee details of whose salary is equal to 3,000. So directly you can give 3,000 like this. You can give like this. Okay. But there is a operator, EQ operator. Okay. So equal to means select documents where the value of a field is equal to specified value 3000. Okay. Next one is NE. NE means as it name itself, not equal. Okay. So it will display the employee documents whose salary is not equal to 3000. Okay. Next one is greater than GT. G for greater, T for than. So it will display the employee details whose salary is greater than 3000. If you put E, then it will display the employee details whose salary is greater than or equal to 3000. That means 3000 will also come. Okay. So like that, LT less than. If you put E less than or equal. Okay. Next. In, not in. Suppose I want to give some employee details, salary values like 3000 and 5000. Then see this. So what are the values you have passed in this array? So that related documents only you will get. Suppose If you put N, that means not in. So you will get the employee details whose salary is not in 3000 and 5000. That is not in. Next. Getting the documents. Sorry, logical query operators. So here we have seen one by one these document these comparison query operators, but in real time, I think we can write like this also, db.emp find. Name greater than less than see this here. I want to display the employee details whose employee name starts with A, that means greater than or equal to A, and less than or equal to C means ends with C. Okay, so employee name starts with A and employee name starts with C. Okay, so A to C. So here employee name starts with A, B. Okay, if you pass K, then if you pass K, then see this Jones. So employee name starts with A. And B, C up to J. J only available, so that it will display until J. Okay. Like that, you can write the queries like emp name dot find. So I want to display the salary details. Whose salary lies between 2000 to 3000. Okay, so these are the employee details whose salary lies between 2000 to 3000. Okay, so like that you can do any type of examples. Okay, next, logical query operators. So db.emp.find. I want to display the employee details whose department number is 30. These are the employee details. It belongs to department number 30. Okay. So I want to display the employee details whose department number is 30 and salary is 1250. Okay. Then how to write the query? Here, two conditions. One is department number should be 30 and salary should be 1250. Okay, then put comma sal 1250. Okay. So 1250, two records are there. And I want to display the department number 30 and salary is 3000, then no records are there. Okay. Now this is AND operator. Okay. So by default it will satisfy AND operation, but you can use same query by using AND keyword. Okay. So how to write this? So here, open these flower brackets and dollar should be there. Okay, for each and every operator, dollar should be there. And open flower square brackets and series. Okay. Right from starting onwards, see this. And open square brackets. Okay. Here, open the flower brackets. So salary 3000 and DATT dot department number 30. No records. So if you give 1250, then you check two records are there. Okay. So then R operator is simple. You put R operator, then what will happen? What will happen? Okay. Yes. So it is here in this square brackets. So I put each and every condition in separated flower brackets. Okay, observe this. Okay. So you can write without separate brackets also, no problem. Then copy here or now see this. So it will consider if you put R in the place of AND, then it will satisfy this R condition. So what is the difference between AND and R means? AND operator returns true if all expressions evaluate to true. OR operations means, so it is a logical OR operation on an array of one or more expressions and selects the documents that satisfies at least one expression. Okay, so here if these are two conditions. If any one of the condition is satisfied, then you will get the documents. Okay. So you can use any one of these for under operation. You can write like this. You can write like this. You can write like this. Okay. So there are many ways to write. The same number of documents you are getting. Next one is NOR means NOR operator allows to perform logical NOR operation in a list of one or more query expressions and selects documents that fail all the query operations. Okay. So like so same example I'm taking. How many records you are getting? 6 records whose salary is either 1250 or department number 30. Suppose if you put 3000, then it will display the records whose salary is 3000 or department number is 30. Okay. So if you use NOR operator, then the salary should not be 3000 and the department number should not 30. See this department number 20, 20, 20, 10, 10, 10. Okay. So these two conditions should not be satisfied. That is NOR operation. So quietly opposite to OR operation. Okay. So whatever you have specified the conditions, the condition should not be satisfied while you are using NOR operator. Whatever you have specified the condition in this array, so that any one of the condition is satisfied, then only you will get the result while using OR operator. If you use AND operator means all conditions should be satisfied. So AND means all conditions should be satisfied. OR means any one of the conditions should be satisfied. NOR means no one should be satisfied. Okay. So remaining records you will get. Next one is NOT. So NOT operation performs logical NOT operations like here. Yeah. See, I want to have the records whose employee names does not start with specified letter. In that cases, we have to use NOT operator. Here, we have seen so many examples whose employee name starts with specified character and whose employee name contains a specified character, all those things. But we didn't see whose employee name does not start with a specified character. NOT AMS, what do you get? Just you will write like this so that you will get employee records whose employee name does not start with letter S. Okay, so same functionality, how can we achieve in MongoDB? Okay. Here. So db dot emp dot find. Dname colon not s. So all the documents you are having. But SC starts with, sorry, Smithy starts with yes. Why it is displaying? Why? Because you didn't use I, ignore case sensitive. Then you will not get Smith. Okay. Turner. Next one is does not start with specified characters including case sensitive. How many records are there? 9 records. Okay, that means so this query displays the employee details whose employer name does not contain the yes letter. Okay, so that's why we are getting 9. So remaining 5 records is having yes letter. Okay. Suppose starts does not starts with yes means cap symbol yes. So yes is okay, 12 records are there. So for remaining records starts with yes. So does not end with yes, that is dollar. Shit. B dot emp dot find the name. Not yes does not ends with yes, it is dollar.